Thank you. The next item of business is an urgent question from Paul Sweeney. I call Paul Sweeney.
The presiding officer, to ask the Scottish Government what its response is to reports following comments made by the Home Secretary in the House of Commons today that local authorities across the UK, including in Scotland, will be obliged to accommodate the increasing number of unaccompanied child refugees crossing the English Channel.
Cabinet Secretary Shona Robinson.
Well, this is of major concern to the Scottish Government, to COSLA and to local authorities. The Home Secretary wrote to all local authorities in July asking for more placements to be made available, and Scotland answered that call by creating a Scottish rota, which is supported by the vast majority of councils and COSLA. This rota has been in operation since October and is working well. It's ensuring that Scotland meets the target set by the Home Office, but it does this in a manner which prioritises the welfare of children, supports their needs and provides them with the best possible chance to integrate into our society. The proposals set out by the UK Government are a retrograde step which will create needless bureaucracy and do little to support the welfare and wellbeing of these highly vulnerable children. I made my views known to the UK Government in a short call with the Minister and will be following that up in writing later today, and I've spoken to COSLA, who are as concerned as I am at the way this has been badly handled by the UK Government.
Paul Sweeney.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that response, and let me just put on record my absolute disgust at the way these vulnerable people, many fleeing war and persecution, have been treated by the Conservative Government simply for seeking a safe place to live. We are dealing with unaccompanied children here, and I think it's really important to be clear on the detail. So I do have a number of questions that I would like the Cabinet Secretary to answer if she can. Could she provide details of how many local authorities across Scotland meet the requirements set out by the Home Office in today's announcement, and how many children are likely to be coming to Scotland? How long the Scottish Government envisages they will be in Scotland, and what work the Scottish Government are doing to make sure that all local authorities have adequate provisions to provide the necessary safeguards to these children while they're in Scotland? What type of accommodation will they be living in? It cannot be the case that they are put in hotels, surely, or unsupervised accommodation, so I would appreciate if the Cabinet Secretary would at least explicitly rule that out in her answer.
Cabinet Secretary.
Paul Sweeney raises a number of issues. Clearly, one of the reasons for the rota was the recognition that there are some Scottish local authorities that are very small, who don't necessarily have the infrastructure to support the unaccompanied asylum-seeking children, and therefore that then puts at risk the support that such a vulnerable child would have. So there are good reasons, which is why the Scottish rota was put together, so that the children arriving in Scotland can go to the most appropriate place. So I can tell the member that the rota will see, would have seen, if it had been allowed to continue, 45 of every 650 children arriving in the UK coming to Scotland. That's actually one more than they're saying they're mandating Scotland to take. On the call yesterday, they said Scotland, the local authorities, would be mandated to take 44 children. So we would actually be more than meeting the requirements, but doing that in a way that supports the children. I can tell that the member that since October, when participation commenced by Scottish local authorities, 19 placements have been made. That's in addition to the 22 children who arrived under the NTS scheme from January to September. And that, in addition to that, there are already around 200 unaccompanied asylum-seeking children already cared for by Scottish local authorities. In terms of the type of accommodation, again, that's an important point. We want children to become... They're going to be here, obviously, for a long time, so we want them to become settled in settled accommodation as quickly as possible. It's in no one's interest for people to be staying in hotels, and we recognise the challenges of that, which is why the Scottish rota is so important, because it is the best way of making sure that appropriate accommodation is made available for the children arriving.
Paul Sweeney.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer, and again I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that response and particularly the detail on the Scottish Rota, though I'd appreciate if some additional information potentially could be followed up in writing. It is right that the Scottish local authorities are providing accommodation to these children, and I do sincerely hope that the Scottish Government will do everything it can to ensure that their time in Scotland will be one where they're treated with dignity, care, compassion that they so clearly need. After all, they are children who have seen unimaginable horror. I just want to be specific, however, on the funding issue, because while it's right that all local authorities in Scotland are playing their part through the ROTA system, they are cash-strapped and frankly don't have the money available to top up the £143 being made available by the UK Government per child per night. So can I ask the Cabinet Secretary to confirm that the Scottish Government, regardless of how much it's going to cost, will provide any additional funding that local authorities require on top of that £143 specified? This is about making sure that kids are safe, and of course we can't put a price on that. So I would strongly urge the Government to show compassion and make that commitment here now, because it's certainly not something we're going to see from the Conservatives.
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I say to the Member, first of all, I think we share COSLA and local government's concern that the National Transfer Scheme does constitute a new financial responsibility on local authorities, and the first call is on the UK Government to provide the additional funding required. So the higher daily rate of £143 for funding contributions to local authorities now applies to those transferring through NTS, and it's a small step acknowledging some of the costs. But it's only available once a child is in the care of the local authority. It doesn't recognise the steps that the local authority requires to take in advance of that placement. Obviously, to help with this, the Scottish Government has already provided £500,000 to local authorities to help with the care of unaccompanied asylum-seeking children arriving in Scotland. And we'll continue to speak and, with local authorities and COSLA about that going forward. But the first call is on the UK Government to step up and meet the full costs.
Thank you. I'll take some supplementaries. First from Miles Briggs.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. 7,900 children in Scotland are currently in temporary accommodation, a 9% increase on 2019, Cabinet Secretary. Seven councils across Scotland are saying they're likely to breach the Scottish Government's unsuitable accommodation order. So what support will the Government be providing? And I don't think necessarily we heard an answer to Paul Sweeney's question in terms of this accommodation. Are hotels going to be part of that process?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, can I say to Miles Briggs that there have been a number of pressures on temporary accommodation, not least we've just been through a COVID situation where obviously a temporary accommodation use has increased for all the understandable reasons. And we're working with local authorities to address the unsuitable accommodation order issues, as the member is aware of. We want children to be in accommodation suitable for children, but can I say to the member that perhaps his first port of call should be his colleagues in the UK government, to say we have a system here in Scotland that is actually made for the needs of Scotland to receive children that need to be supported because they are very vulnerable. All we are asking is the Home Office allows the Scottish ROTA to continue. We play our part, we will take our share of these very vulnerable children, but please let us do it in a managed, proper way, rather than in a way that the Home Office is saying they're going to, which could, in theory, mean children being passed from one local authority to another around Scotland. That is not what we want to happen, and I hope the member will support us in lobbying the Home Office to do the right thing here.
A supplementary from Co-Cab Stewart.
Thank you. I was shocked to hear the Home Secretary, Priti Patel's comments that Scotland has not played their part in asylum dispersal when this country has a proud record of welcoming refugees and asylum seekers. Does the Cabinet Secretary agree that the Home Secretary must apologise for this misleading claim and believe that asylum dispersal, both children and adults, must be done in a humane and dignified way and with the proper funding from the Home Office to provide the vital support the people need?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I say to Kokab Chirrut, yes, I do agree with that, and I'm really struggling to understand the remarks from the Home Secretary yesterday, which are extremely disappointing. We've constantly, over the years, made this point to the UK government, but it's fallen on deaf ears. We have, Scotland has more than played its part, and Glasgow, of course, is an authority throughout the UK that takes the most asylum seekers as part of the dispersal programme. So it is not correct, the comments that she made, and does a great disservice actually to local government and the efforts that they are making. But most of all, Deputy Presiding Officer, it I think attempts to really use asylum-seeking children and asylum seekers more generally as a bit of a political football to attack the Scottish Government. This issue is too important for that. We want to reach a sensible agreement with the UK Government and the Home Office, and my plea today is for them to listen to what, not just what the Scottish Government is saying, but what local authorities are saying. We want to give asylum-seeking children in particular the best support here in Scotland. Please allow us to do it in a way that we know will work best for them.
And supplementary, Maggie Chapman.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I thank Paul Sweeney for raising this important issue, highlighting the human rights that are at stake here and the appalling approach taken by the UK Government. Can the Cabinet Secretary say what, if any, role the Scottish Guardianship Service will have in this process, what we can do to support local authorities to work with the third sector, who have been doing this work for so many years? And finally, what we can do, if anything, with our limited powers to ensure that lone children are not separated from their families in the first place?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, can I say to Maggie Chapman on the issue of the Scottish Guardianship Service, I'll write to her on that specific point. But the role of the third sector more generally has always been important for asylum seekers and refugees. It is through the support of the third sector that they receive most of their support, and we are keen to support the third sector in doing that. There were some very strong voices from the third sector yesterday in response to the Home Secretary's comments, which portrayed the Home Secretary as not giving a proper account of the experience of asylum seekers coming here to Scotland. So I think the third sector is pretty clear on their views on that matter, but I'll write to the member on the specifics of her question.